Hello, welcome again to another video on understanding insurance claims. I'm Jim Buford, and I hope to enlighten you a little bit on what to expect on a, today we'll be talking about property claims, what to expect before your adjuster comes to the scene. I know you'll have a lot of questions, everyone always does, and I just want to touch on a few of the questions that you might have and what sort of responses you will probably get. One thing is always be sure that you confirm names, phone numbers, email address, and those kinds of things. Be sure that also you let your insurance adjuster or company know what your numbers are and when you can most likely be contacted. In other words, you may work during the day, or you may work during the night and sleep during the day and so forth, but always let them know when is the best time for you to be contacted. That way, when your adjuster calls, you can more easily set up an appointment and help to expedite your claim and the inspection of your claim. And some questions you may have is along the line of, what about if I need temporary repairs? What if it's a wind damage to my roof and I need to put a tarp on it? Will the insurance company pay for that? Will they send someone out? Should I tend to that? And for instance, if you've had a fire and maybe your house needs to be boarded up, maybe there are windows that are blown out or windows that are burned out, and in order to help prevent additional damage and possibly theft from your home, it's always good to board up things when you can to help protect the property. So you need to clear up those questions and be sure that there's an understanding there. And if you have a contractor in mind, you might want to ask the adjuster, should I have my contractor available? It usually speeds things up if the contractor that you intend to use, if you have selected a contractor, is present when the adjuster makes his inspection. That way they can agree on the scope of the damage, the overall damage that they see, and then each one can begin to prepare an estimate for the repairs. So that's always good. And you may have questions about, what if I need an advance payment? I don't have, all of my clothes are burned and I don't have anything. Most companies will provide an advance payment after they make an inspection. It may just be a temporary type inspection, just enough to confirm that the loss occurred and where it occurred and make you an advance payment. But you need to ask those questions if they're not already answered, perhaps by the agent. And if you need temporary housing, how do you handle that? If you don't know, when you talk to your adjuster, say, hey, I don't have a place to live. What does my policy cover? So clear up those kinds of issues before the adjuster gets there, and will make things go much smoother. Also, if perhaps someone has run into your home with their automobile and has created damage, you need to know, should I call the police? Should I get a police report? Usually it's best if you do. Certainly if you can get a report by the time the adjuster gets there, it'll help greatly. But if you can't, at least be sure that the police are notified. And should you contact your mortgage company? Many people don't know who their mortgage company is. They might have to do a little investigation, but it may be a sizable claim that you want to go ahead and contact your mortgage company. Anything that you can do on the front end before the adjuster arrives will help expedite your claim. And that's what one of the things that you and your insurance company wants to do. And another question you may have is, if I do some cleanup, if I do some temporary repairs, will I be paid? And will I be paid at the same rate as a contractor? Typically, you won't be paid at the same rate, even though you will be paid for any repairs, any temporary repairs or whatever that you do. One reason you won't be paid at the same rate is because any contractor has a certain amount of overhead that the homeowner doesn't have. So typically you're not going to be paid at the same rate, but you will be paid for any services that you provide that eliminates the possibility of hiring someone else to do it. But again, one of the main things you need to do is be sure that all phone numbers, whether they're yours or a contact or a friend or whomever that you will depend on to get in touch with you in the event the insurance company calls, be sure that those numbers are available, both your numbers and that you get their numbers. So there's no question about how to reach you. Again, those are just a few of the points that I think would be beneficial, and it's not intended to be all inclusive, but these are some ideas that will help you greatly to get your claim moving in the right direction and do as much as you can do prior to the time that the insurance adjuster arrives on the scene. I hope this will be a help to you. And again, I appreciate you watching. And if you like this video, please hit the subscribe button. And again, have a nice day. Thank you.